Now, if you were not pregnant, you're just a regular person, you get the Zika virus, what could be the long-term effect for you?
As of now, in the studies, there are no long-term effects.
Okay.
It's a self-limiting illness, so you recover. And most of the illnesses do not need hospitalization.
I see. Mm-hmm. So
it's very mild.
So in other words, it's like a regular virus. You boost your immune mm-hmm. system, and then you'll be okay.
Yes.
Okay. Now, I know that you came from Cuba mm-hmm. recently because President Duterte has been harping on the Cuban model, no, for healthcare.
Yes.
What is so unique about the Cuban model?
In Cuba, the medical school is under the health department.
Okay.
They produce the number of doctors that they need. Mm-mm. So they're human resource. So what's peculiar about Cuba is the human resource to population ratio. They have one doctor for every 1,075 population.
Is that good?
Yes, that's very good.
What do we have?
We have one doctor is to 33,000
good God.
Population.
And what?
And the WHO recommendation is one doctor to 20,000.
So it means that Cuba is exceptional.
Yes.
There are so many doctors in Cuba. So why is that? Is it because education is free?
Yes, the education for doctors and many health professionals are free.
Completely. Provided. Allowances. Kasi dito, when you say free, it's not completely free. You're spending for miscellaneous and other things. Mm-hmm. What's the Cuban model?
In Cuba, it's a whole campus. They have a dormitory. They have students staying there. They provide for everything, the uniform, the books, everything. It's completely free.
And what are the rules? In other words, if you become a doctor or a health worker because of the Cuban government, are you required to serve?
Yes.
Okay, what are the rules?
They have a three-year mandatory service to government. So you actually do not choose where you go, and then they assign you, and then after 3 years, you can have the option, or you are provided options to go into specialization.
Oh. So we don't have that in the Philippines, no?
No.
Not at all?
In other words, if you're trying.
Yeah.
UP.
But then it's not completely free kasi.
Yes.
Yeah.
But what we're trying to do is also to advocate to the state-owned universities and colleges, and we have about 7 of them, to actually do mandatory return service. But the problem before, Karen, is that the Department of Health didn't have the budget to pay for salaries of the doctors. Mm-hmm. In Cuba, the doctors are paid very low. It's about $60 a month.
But why do they do it?
Because they're required by government.
That's the good part. Yes. But then do they go, I'm curious, you've been there, do they go hungry?
No.
Or it's enough?
Actually, when the doctors graduate, they are provided housing.
Yon.
Their food is subsidized. The education of the children is free. So
no
they
wonder.
Have benefits.
Oh, the support is strong.
Yes.
Now, you need 82 billion pesos to follow the Cuban model. Mm-hmm. Where would you spend the 82?
But our main problem right now, we don't produce enough doctors.
Yeah.
The 82 billion is actually salaries for the doctors who would render return service scholarship for the doctors to finish medicine. In Cuba, medicine is 6 years. In the Philippines, it's about 9 years.
So would you change that?
We're studying it. UP is actually doing it. The intermed program of 7 years.
Uh-oh.
6 years medicine and 1 year internship.
Uh-oh.
So it's a shorter course than the 9 years we usually have.
But is there also a psychological reason why more people get into medicine in Cuba and not so much in the Philippines?
Well, I think the benefits are the ones that people in Cuba are looking into. That if you become a doctor, you have...
Free housing. Schooling.
Then you can go to further studies and you have specialization. And after your specialization and return service, actually they allow you to now go in whatever country you want to be assigned.
Uh-oh. And where does Cuba get the money for this? I'm sure you asked that.
It's fully funded by government. Actually, in Cuba, the health budget is about 26% of the national budget. In the Philippines, it's about less than 6%.
Yes, because I think if it's 26%, we're talking about education.
Yes.
That's the one that would have that kind of budget. So in Cuba, 26% is health.
Yes.
Wow. Are you going to get a better budget come 2017?
Well, we're making a proposal, like looking at the entire health system and actually... providing options.
Yes.
If we do this, this is how much it will take.
Uh-oh. Okay.